also caught on camera. A prescription pot shop takes a hit. Not once, but possibly targeted twice. Medical marijuana in high demand. But in one case, the crook may have been hitting it a little too hard before the crime. News 4's Brent Skarke following the story. And Brent, this is because the would-be thief broke into the wrong store altogether, possibly.
Yeah, that's what the owner of the dispensary thinks. Now, they know for sure they were hit over the weekend because they've got the guy on camera, but they think maybe a criminal tried to break down a wall in their shop, all in an effort to get cash.
We do believe he's from the area.
Kent Malave, talking about this man, caught on camera, brazenly stealing products from this North Edmond dispensary.
Another customer walked in behind, came over and started opening one of our glass displays. Reached over those glass displays and grabbed about $1,000 worth of product and walked out with that product.
Malave owns this shop at Waterloo and Broadway. They sell CBD, medical marijuana, and over the weekend,
somebody was inside of the store and actually reached around and grabbed some product from behind the counter.
But Malave says this is not the first time they've been targeted by thieves. A couple weeks back, he thinks someone tried to break in Outback, overshot his store, and ended up in the sandwich shop next door.
So you think this guy was actually trying to get to you guys?
Absolutely. I think that he was going through here, and I think he counted the wrong number of doors and thought that he was in our building, and when he went the wrong direction, ended up in Subway. Torn some of this up. They pulled this back. This is all bowed out. So he got inside and got to the cinder blocks and started beating up on those.
So why the multiple hits by criminals?
I think we're being targeted mainly because we're an all-cash business. That's what people are really trying to go after.
Malave says thanks to medical marijuana still being illegal on the federal level, dispensaries can't use banks. That means both customers and employees have to handle large amounts of cash on site.
Puts a lot of people in jeopardy.
As for the man in the pictures and the video,
we'd like to get this guy off the streets because if he steals from us, he's stealing from you as well.
Well, Malave says there's actually legislation out of Oregon in Washington, D.C. currently that could make it legal for dispensaries to use banks. But right now, police need your help identifying that man in the video. If you have any information, contact police.